Hey Flyers fans, this is Sports Fanatic News. I'm Joe Boric, and a special thanks to those of you that have subscribed. Please continue to subscribe down below on the sub button or up above on the easy-to-use Professor Joe widget at the end of the video. Let's get right into the video. After showing some promising offensive sequences and better tape-to-tape passes last game against Colorado, that the offensive pace was a little bit better, and it's not like Yo had a practice then. It all fell to shambles yet again for the Flyers. They only had one good offensive output game. And to make it worse, they only have one more win. Two or one in the last 10 for the New Jersey Devils. They weren't playing better hockey overall coming into this game. And in the first period, you got trounced in the puck possession. It was lucky to be 1-0 coming out of that period. And then in the second period, our Philadelphia Flyers then had a goal scored on them by Jesper Bratt, where Sanheim, who was, I would say, a lot of people didn't stand out yesterday. Frost was one of the guys that did have energy, I would have to say. He looked pretty good, and then McEwen was laying his hits. But my good buddy Zach, that used to write for Nitty Gritty before he got his full-time job, he made up the great point, which is, or brought up the great point, which is McEwen's kind of has to, we have to get somebody, whether it's Zach, whether it's Rasmus Ristolainen, whether it's Scott Laudon, whoever, that just kind of drops the gloves early to set the tempo. You might have passed that threshold at this point, though, because the teams are smart. They won't do that against us because you don't want to wake a potential sleeping lion, if that's what some people around the league might think the Flyers could be, since Yo is a coach that has the potential to go on runs once he gets a practice. Like JJ said on the broadcast, maybe they'll try to finagle a practice into either as soon as they get down in Vegas, try to get one in as soon as possible, or depending what the travel plans were, get one in Jersey and then fly down to Vegas since there's a gap day there. But I don't think they're going to beat the Vegas Golden Knights. I mean, I can't predict that at all. I thought after the Colorado game, my key takeaways were, well, you built on the offense. The defense was still doo-doo, obviously, to give up 7. But you built on that offensive play. You had better tape-to-tape passes. You had better pace, where pace isn't the same thing as speed, obviously. I brought that up on Pirlo Wisdom's show. Give him a follow as well. But pace is just quick decision-making, split-second decision-making is what leads to good pace. The Flyers sometimes have 5-second decision-making where they look like those quarterbacks in the NFL that get sacked 45 times a season because they don't make a read right away and just hold on to the puck for too long. So that's one of the key takeaways that showed back up immediately in this game. Another key takeaway is, what the hell is going on with defending the front of the net? Obviously, the first play, Travis Sanheim wiped out, and then Jesper Bratt was able to get it over Carter Hart, who probably did go down a little bit early there, but that is what it is. Travis Sanheim wiping out was the big key factor in that play to why he was able to score. And then I don't know what the hell Travis Sanheim's doing. When that was his man, also, Risto could have picked him up better, too. But that was, as far as I understand, his dude. Dawson Mercer was just wide open. That was a beautiful deflection by the kid to get his 7th goal. That was like a Joe Pavelski deflection. But the dude was wide open in front of the net. So it makes it significantly easier to get that deflection. The net front defense, the defense in general just wasn't good yesterday. This was really one of those games, I would have to say. Like, the Devils are a very good, young, talented, have young, really good, young, talented skill. I didn't agree with Taryn Hatcher when she brought it up. Like, they're not, like, when she kind of dissed them a little bit, comparing them to the Avalanche, because you can't really compare many teams to Colorado's level of skill other than, like, Tampa Bay. But they do have a lot of good, young skill. But when it comes to this New Jersey Devils team, I think we would have got beat more. Like, if we were playing Vegas and we played them like we did yesterday, that would have been 6-0, 7-0. Like, that would have been a much better, just to put that in perspective, that would have been a much better game for the opponent and a much worse game for us if it was against one of those teams or against Colorado again, and we played them like that and just had a dead offense that showed absolutely nothing. I mean, this was just, I kind of, at this point, in terms of answers, I think it's Yo has to get his first practice in, whether he's able to get that in before the game in Vegas. They then have to fly down to Arizona, which I swear we better find a way to beat Arizona, who plays a good game style with Tourney, but obviously they don't have overall. They have a lot of guys that are at the end of their careers that they're just getting another chance to play in the NHL, like the Lads of the world and others down there mixed in with the star players like Clayton Keller. So hopefully we're able to actually beat Arizona. And then they also, of course, have former Flyer Gostisbehere, who I could easily see going off against us. And then, like, other guys, like I said, Jay Beagle. And then, kind of towards the end, Phil Kessel probably will get traded. Strawman, a guy that's definitely towards the tail end of his career. So they got a lot of those, like, older guys and then mixed in with some of their young talent. But they play a good, systematic game. Down there, they just don't have the skill to obviously generate the wins, per se, where the Flyers haven't played a good systematic game for the last, I wouldn't even say it's just the losing streak. We grinded out some wins against Calgary, which was great to see, and also Washington, but it's been for like the last 12 to 13 games, that's why I wouldn't be shocked, but I would be heated if we lose to a team that might lose their arena due to back taxes coming up. But that game's on Sunday. Obviously, the next one's against Vegas. I don't have high hopes for Philadelphia Flyers, unfortunately, in Las Vegas, because how could I with the way the Vegas Golden Knights have played more of late and the way our Philadelphia Flyers have played of late? The Vegas Golden Knights have been a lot better lately, or where our Philadelphia Flyers, of course, have not been, and even last night, they were able to grind out a 5-4 win over the Dallas Stars, when it looked like for most of that game, even though they were out shooting Dallas, Dallas was going to figure out a way to get the W in that game, but no, in the last 10 minutes of the third period, Vegas really just took it to Dallas and was able to win that game, and Dallas has been the hottest team in hockey going into that game, so I think the Vegas Golden Knights are coming in hot as firecrackers. You already know how good the team is in general. Not a good spelling for the Flyers, but I'll be doing a preview for that game tomorrow before that tilt. Everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day. This has been a reaction to last night's 3-0, which was really a blowout win by the Devils. You don't always say a 3-0 win is a blowout win, but the Flyers had nothing going for them yesterday. That was a 3-0 blowout win by the Devils. And the Flyers got to get it going. They got to find it. I mean, there's nothing going right now. There was something on Monday against the Avalanche. It looked like it was something to build on. And then it's just dead again on Wednesday against the Devils, who are, of course, not as good of a team at this point. Great young talent, like I said, but not to the level of that Avalanche team. And you looked woefully awful against them. So everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day. This has been the reaction slash some key factors we mixed in video against the New Jersey Devils, where we lost 3-0. Peace out, everybody. Stay safe, and hopefully we can figure this out and get a W on the board, I would say, against Arizona, because I don't see it happening against Vegas. Peace out, everybody, and stay safe.